Well, sounds very stupid to me. But I had a dog once named Stupid. That might be a good omen. Okay, our play is Betty. First practice is tomorrow. Everybody take three left and hit the showers. Let's go!
In my opinion, the quality of material chosen for high school performances is absolutely appalling. A play must be spiritually uplifting for the audience and challenging for the actors. This rule of thumb, of course, eliminates nearly 90% of the plays ever written. Remember, the work performed by high school students must be challenging.
Channel. Almost. And for this year's one act, we will perform Shakespeare's classic tragedy, King Lear, in the style of Grand Kabuki.
Kabuki? That's Japanese, isn't it?
But I can't speak Japanese. How am I supposed to be the lead if I can't even speak Japanese?
I'll arrange for a special tutor who will teach us all to speak Japanese.
But we only have 6 weeks.
You mean you're going to take one of Shakespeare's greatest tragedies, produce it into a 30-minute one-act play, translate it into Japanese, learn to speak Japanese, and then produce it in the style of Grand Kabuki? All in 6 weeks.
Well, of course. It will require some dedication on your part.
Dedication? We'll have to live here.
Well, of course.
You mean eat here, sleep here, take showers here, live here?
Well, of course.
And what about our friends?
Unnecessary distractions.
Our families?
They may visit you Sunday mornings from 10 to 12, at which time they may participate in the energy cleansing dance off.
Wait, if I do all of this, will I still be the lead?
I know my boyfriend will dump me, but I'll see him for 6 weeks.
And I have to go to the hospital twice a week for my rash treatment.
Will you stop complaining? I have spent years of my life preparing for this project, and it will doubtless be remembered as the single greatest artistic event of the 20th century.
It's a high school play festival.
This is not just a play festival. It is ritual. It is society. It is a living, breathing, touching, feeling, thinking embodiment of art. It is theater.
It's a bunch of pizza-faced teenagers trying to embarrass themselves too badly.
I offer you the experience of a lifetime, and you're complaining about trivialities? Where is your spirit? Where is your loyalty? Where's your dedication to art? Remember, greatness is never achieved without sacrifice.
Sounds doable.
Are you?
What are you?
A drama wimp or a drama stud?
What?
Look, your friends are losers. Who needs them? Your family will never miss you. And if your boyfriend dumps you, there's always the captain of the football team.
And what about my rash?
So you missed a few doctor's appointments. I missed lots of doctor's appointments, and I'm still living. So are we gonna do this thing, or what?
Sure, might be fun.
Okay, did you mention who gets the lead yet?
So that's settled. Now, who is this spear shaker guy?
My least favorite part of any play is the audition. Before they start, you're terrified. It could be depression or ecstasy. Auditions!
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio, a fellow of infinite jest, of most excellent fancy. He hath bore me on his back 1,000 times, and how bored in my imagination it is. My gorge rises at it.
Stop! What is this? What is this?
It's a skull.
I know it's a skull, bonehead. What are you doing talking to it?
I'm doing a soliloquy from Hamlet, Eddie.
Hamlet? That's Shakespeare, right?
Right.
No wonder I didn't understand what you were talking about. Listen, the name of the play is Betty. There's no skulls in it, and everyone talks American, okay?
Okay.
Good form. So, how much do you weigh?
230.
Ever play football?
No way. I'm an actor.
And a rocker. You've got absolutely no experience. But compared to Larry and Moe over there, you're the closest thing I've got to a football player. All right, you get the part of Buck, captain of the football team.
That's it? You don't even hear me read?
No, you don't have to read to play football. So, which one of you is older?
She is.
Okay, you get the part of the snow fairy that meets Betty Greenwood. And you get the part of one of the penguins that takes your baby away.
Coach, who's Betty?
You look like Betty.
So what are you trying to say? I look like some stupid bimbo who'd give birth in Greenland and then throw herself into the Arctic Ocean? What about her?
Yeah, what about me?
You'll do it.
I'll look like a jerk.
You will do it.
Her father's on the school board.
Congratulations, Sue.
While it is true that all actors must be suitable for their roles, what is really important is that everyone be treated fairly.
Hi, Sheila. Say, would you like to go to the Arbor Day dance with me?
Why, Herbie, you sly thing. I'd love to.
Cool. I'll pick you up Friday at 7:15. Wait till I tell the guys. Now we'll see who's the nerd.
Wonderful! Now, what wouldn't you?
Miss Duncan's mantra, we've been at this for 3 days. Every single person's read every single line on every single page of the first 5 scenes.
I'm aware of that, and we have 9 more pages to go in only 2 days. We mustn't fall behind schedule, or...
Aren't you driving us all crazy?
I'm beginning to hate this play, not even recording it yet.
I think Miss Duncan's mantra should be praised for her fairness.
Shut up, you brown noser.
That'll be enough of that!
Sorry.
No offense, Miss Hawkinsmarsh, but Jill does get all the lead roles.
I beg your pardon.
It's true, she always gets the best part.
I'm shocked by your attitude. This is the very reason that we auditioned so thoroughly. To ensure a fair chance to all. If Jill happens to get the lead role, it's because her talents are far superior to yours. I can't believe there are still directors who audition by repeated readings of lines from a script. What creativity is there in that? Please, plumb the depths of the actor's soul. Force him or her to expose their soul. Only then will you know what they truly have to offer.
Now, we are all wounded butterflies.
Wounded!
Now we are all trees in a calm summer's day. A gentle breeze rustles through your leaves. A little freer, Laura. Very nice, York. Suddenly, the wind picks up. It is whipping you back and forth. The power is incredible. The force is such a finish roll upward and slam to the ground.
Wonderful.
Superb. She took my breath away.
That was a great warm up, Miss Mellencamp.
Yeah, are we ready to start the auditions now?
Oh, Allison, that was your audition.
That was our audition?
Yes.
But we didn't even say anything.
Not so. You spoke to me through your movements.
You mean you're going to cast a play by one of the world's greatest poets based on her acting like trees, and rocks, and butterflies? You have to be joking.
This is not a joke, Elliot. But nobody talked.
What's the difference? We're all going to be speaking Japanese anyway.
I just wish I would have known. I know my truth has been strong.
Now you all did beautifully, Callie. And if you'll all settle down, I'll announce the cast.
You know what parts we get? Don't you have to think about it or something?
For the true artist, Elliot, thinking always takes a backseat to inspiration. Now, the part of King Lear will be played by Bjork.
Cool.
Reagan, Allison, Goneril, Laura, and Edgar, Edmund, Albany, Cornwall, Stimpy, and Kim will all be played by Elliot.
All who speak Japanese.
And Callie will play Cordelia.
Wait. She's the lead, right?
Well, she has fewer lines and is on stage less than all the other sisters, but yes, she's the lead.
I got the lead! I got the lead! Oh my gosh, I got the lead!
I'm so glad.
Now, I'm sure you're all emotionally drained, so let's break for supper. Oh, I'm also happy to announce that all our meals will be catered by the House of Tofu Surprise Restaurant on Elm Street. Tonight's menu will include acorn squash, black bean soup, brown rice, and tofu wedges. Bon appetit!
I wish we were having Angus burgers.
The most important part of the play production happens during rehearsals. Whether you're on stage constantly or sit and wait for 2.5 hours to reach your one line, every rehearsal is essential. In no particular order, rehearsals.
Freeze! Experience the space. Feel the presence of those around you. Remove your blindfolds. This is where you will be at the opening of the play. Elliot, your first line, please.
Miss Mellencamp, I'm back to the audience.
I see that, Elliot.
And Kelly's blocking me.
I see that too, Elliot.
Isn't it amazing that even blindfolded, the lead would naturally gravitate to